For our project, we're going to be using Markdown. So I do want to take a couple of minutes to review some of the basics of Markdown. Now, you may be already familiar with Markdown, so you can go ahead and skip this if you are. If you're still around, let's take a look at the basics. For an H1 heading, you use a pound and then your heading text. And if we take a look at the HTML generated, you see an H1, then the text, and then the closing tag. For an H2, you use 2 pounds, another heading. And sure enough, we get H2 and our heading text. For an H3, you would use 3 pounds, yet another heading. And if we look at the HTML, you see the H3. I think you get the point. Another thing that you can do is unordered lists. Now, to make one, you use the plus sign and then your item. So we'll say plus item 1 plus item 2 plus item 3. Let's take a look at that. Perfect. Unordered list and then 3 list items. What about italics? Well, to do that, you will use an asterisk. So 1 asterisk where you want it to start and 1 asterisk where you want it to end. And now we see that item 1 is italicized. For bold, you would do the same, but with 2 asterisks. So 1, 2 at the beginning and 1, 2 to stop. And there we go. We see item 2 is bold. Now, if you want it bold and italics, you may have guessed it, you would use 3. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. And there we go. Item 3 is bold and italics. The next thing I want to show you is a block quote. To start a block quote, you simply put a greater than sign and then your quote. Now, the way that this actually looks will vary from parser to parser, but the generated HTML will always be the same. What about code blocks? That's another really cool feature of Markdown. To start a code block, you would use 3 ticks, that is the key that's on top of your tab. And then you can even specify what language you're going to be using. So in our example, we'll use PHP. Now let's start our code block here. We'll say PHP variable. Cool. And then to end your code block, you will add 3 ticks again. Let's take a look at that. Wow, look at that. We even have syntax highlighting. That's pretty cool. Now, that is happening because we specified a language. If we don't specify the language, it will simply just generate a generic code block. But that is a nice feature. So we'll put PHP back on, and sure enough, you get nice syntax highlighting. For this test, we've been using parsedown.org. And this is actually the package that we're going to be using. Markdown Parser is actually used in the Laravel framework, which means that we are not pulling in any additional packages. And more than likely, it's already inside your vendor directory. Now, there's a lot more to learn about Markdown, but these very basics will get us through basically this entire course.